This video provides an overview of integrating HR service delivery on the ServiceNow platform with third-party HR management systems. Linked time codes for these topics appear in the YouTube description for this video. With the HR Integrations plugin, you can integrate HR service delivery with third-party HR management systems that use SOAP or REST services. In the Kingston release, base integrations are provided for Workday, which uses SOAP services to synchronize employee profile and leave of absence data, and SuccessFactors, which uses SOAP and REST services to synchronize employee profile data. You can also integrate with other third-party HR management systems. Here's what the process looks like. First, you provide the source credentials so that HR service delivery can access the external system. Second, you need to configure and/or verify the inbound integration. Third, you repeat this step for the outbound integration. Finally, you schedule the integrations job. Let's look at the first part of the process, providing the source credentials. We start by opening an existing source or creating a new source where we provide information about the third-party system. When creating a new source, provide the name of the third-party HR management system and make sure the active checkbox is selected. If you're using Workday or SuccessFactors, open the existing record to configure it. The source properties, additional inputs, and source versions, if applicable, are already set up for you. Here we enter the credentials for the SOAP services that we'll be using with the integration. Both Workday and SuccessFactors use SOAP services. SuccessFactors also uses REST services, but we don't configure them here. We'll show you where to add them later when we configure the inbound integration. Here's where you configure the source properties, such as debug, dry run, enable auto update, and others. You can activate or deactivate the available source properties as needed. For example, if you wanted to perform a dry run of the integration to validate the integration data, activate the debug and dry run properties by selecting true in the value field. Some third-party systems require additional information, which you enter here in additional inputs. For example, the SuccessFactors integration requires the company ID as an additional input. Here's an example. If different XPaaS must be used with different versions of the third-party system, you can create different source versions here. For example, the Workday integration is available in two versions, 24.1 or 28.2, and we can switch between them by activating only one at a time. Now let's look at the second part of the process, configuring the inbound integration. Here you determine what data to pull from the third-party system to the HR tables in the ServiceNow platform. For example, the base integration for Workday pulls employee profile data, including departments, locations, job profiles, worker profiles, effective worker profiles, and future worker profiles. The base integration for SuccessFactors pulls the same employee profile data minus future worker profiles. You verify or configure these in the HR Integration Services list. Here you define the HR staging tables that data from the third-party system will be pulled to. Here's a hint. If you're not sure what staging table to specify, you can look up the list of tables by navigating to System Definition, Tables, and searching for table names starting with SN, HR, Integrations. Next, you need to verify or configure the HR web services, which are the SOAP and/or REST messages used to communicate with the third-party system. Earlier in the video, we saw where to configure the SOAP credentials in the HR integration sources. If you're using REST services, as with SuccessFactors, you configure the REST credentials in the basic auth profile here. Next, you need to configure or verify the HR service mapping, which maps the HR integration services to the appropriate HR web services. Here, the HR integration service, departments, is mapped to the Workday HR web service. Next, you need to check the HR schema mapping to verify or configure the mapping for the data fields from the third-party system to the appropriate fields in the HR staging tables. As an example, here's the mapping for the employee's home phone. Finally, you need to check the HR transform maps, which determine the relationships between fields in an import set and fields in an existing ServiceNow table, such as HR profile or department. Here we can see the script that handles the home phone variable. So how do all of these pieces fit together in an inbound integration? A schedule or an event triggered in the ServiceNow platform starts the process of pulling data from the HR system using the HR service mapping configuration, which binds the source and web services. Credentials allow access so that the SOAP and REST services can retrieve the data. The data is parsed and mapped using the HR schema mapping and sent to the HR staging table. Finally, the data in the table is transformed via the HR transform maps and sent to the HR profile table in the platform. Now let's look at the third part of our process, configuring the outbound integration. Here you determine what data to push to the third-party system. Note that you don't need to configure or verify an outbound integration for SuccessFactors. There are two ways to push data to the third-party system, from the HR tables or directly from an HR service. Let's look at a Workday outbound integration as an example. We group the records by HR external source, and in the Workday group, we can see the various mappings. Note that what falls under the HR integration service column is for the inbound integration. We can see here that change legal name and maintain contact information is pushed from the HR tables. The HR integration outbound services define the source tables the data will be pushed from, and leave of absence is pushed from an HR service. Whether you're pushing data from an HR table or an HR service, you also need to configure or verify three additional items. HR web services define the SOAP and/or REST messages used to communicate with the third-party system. HR service mappings map the HR integration outbound services or HR services to the appropriate HR web services for the outbound integration. HR outbound schema mappings map the data fields from the source tables to the appropriate fields in the target system. Let's see how all of this works together in an outbound integration. A schedule or an event triggered in the ServiceNow platform starts the process of pushing data from the HR table or HR service. The HR web services transfer the data to the HR external interface, which is another table in the ServiceNow platform. The HR service mapping configuration binds the source and web services. The HR outbound schema mapping maps the data from the source tables to the fields in the target system. Credentials provide access to the target system, and the data is incorporated into that system. Now let's look at the fourth and final part of our process, scheduling the integrations job. Here in the scheduled script execution, you schedule the integration to run on a daily, weekly, monthly, or on-demand basis. For scheduled jobs, ensure the active checkbox is selected. For our example, let's execute this job now. We can track our integration jobs in the HR Integration Job Trackers list. Here's the job we just executed, and it's still running. In the job record, we can track the status of each HR integration service job in this related list. After the integration job is complete, we can verify whether or not all of the HR integration service jobs completed successfully. For more information, please consult our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.